Hey, bonus video time here. You know, I can't help myself. I wanted to show you at least one way of resetting that revision number. And actually, there is one very simple method actually that we'll see in action. But I wanted to show you this from Cisco's website. I know they mentioned the 3560 here, but this will work on just about any switch. And it's just their usual regular old configuring VTP section. And when I looked at it, that's why this is, I was doing a find, so these are all highlighted. But notice that Cisco goes to the same links I'm going to tell you, hey, this is something you really got to look at, because they mention it in their own VTP configuration page. Before you add a client switch to a VTP domain, you got to make sure that revision number is lower than the revision number of the other switches, because switches in a VTP domain always use the VLAN config of the switch with the highest VTP revision number. If you add a switch that has a revision number higher than the revision number in the VTP domain, it can erase all VLAN information from the VTP server and VTP domain. I seem to have heard that somewhere before. But you can see Cisco says it's going to be just as bad as I do. And they've got one procedure here. I've seen others in their books, but this one is a very simple one. All they actually have you do, and actually, this was something too. I wanted to show you this particular version number bit. Like I said, they're not going to go into that much detail in VTP on your exam, but this is something for you to know. With VTP version 3, the latest version, that VLAN information would not be erased. With versions 1 and 2, and there's still a lot of 2 out there, believe me, it would be. So it's just good policy, period, to reset it to 0. This is all you got to do. All you really need to do is change the domain name from the original one to a new one. And that's actually going to reset your revision. And it should be reset to 0. Always run show VTP status to make sure it has been. And then you just go back and put the original domain name back on the switch or whatever you need to name it. But just always make sure that the configuration revision number is 0. So basically, you're changing the name from A to B to then whatever you need it to be. So let's go ahead and bring the live equipment up, because I did this. Let me see if I can get it all on the screen there. Yep. I actually did this during the break, and we've got show VTP status there. All I did was use the VTP domain CCNA command, and I also wanted to reinforce with you the case sensitivity, because notice the switch isn't saying, hey, you already belong to that domain. The switch is saying changing VTP domain name from uppercase CCNA to lowercase CCNA. So I did that, ran show VTP status, and you can see the configuration revision number was set to 0. Now, if I wanted to set it back to the uppercase CCNA, it would be at 0 and you'd be ready to go. But always verify it one more time. We're always happy when we're verifying, right? So that is much more than you'll need to know about VTP for your exam, but it's definitely information you need to know for real-world networking, because when a client switch goes down and people just start looking for equipment to scrounge out of a rack, people get a little frantic. They forget that one little important detail. That's it for VTP. I'll see you on the next vid.